Hello children, good morning. Today we are talking about a house good and clean. The proper topic today we will talk about how a house should be good and clean. Now it is responsibility of each of us, every member of the family, to keep the house neat and clean. Whether it should be an occasion of some special day or in our day-to-day life, we need to keep our house clean. Because at times you will find there are small kids in the house. They may be get infected because of dust or untidiness kept in the house. So we need to be clean. Not only talking about the small kids, even the grown-ups also get infected because of dust or unwanted things in our house, maybe insects or any other unwanted things. So children, it is responsibility of each and every one of us who stays in the house should keep our house clean. Now let us talk, what should we follow, what should we do to keep our house clean? First of all, we talk about throw waste materials in a dustbin. Now, when we talk about the waste material in a dustbin, there are generally, if I divide the color of dustbin, there are two types of dustbin generally known, that is blue dustbin and green dustbin. Now, in this blue dustbin, we talk about the things, all dry things we dump it, like bottles or glasses or tins, anything which is dry in the blue dustbin. And the green dustbin talks about the kitchen waste, plant waste or animal waste, maybe all the wet things, maybe vegetable peels and leftover food, and these all things we throw it in the green dustbin. Why? Because we want to differentiate, we want to wipe away the dry things differently and the wet things differently. But in general, we don't have two dustbins at our house. So what? What to do? Now, if you don't have two dustbins, no problem. You can throw your waste in the same dustbin, but you can do it separately in this. Generally, we find black polythene available for waste materials. So throw waste materials. You can take two different black poly so that you can throw different materials in different that means the wet materials in one, wet polycarbonate, and while the dry materials in dry polycarbonate. Okay, so all the things used in the house, if it is waste, you should throw in a dustbin. You should not lie here and there. Suppose you are working in your doing your homework, some sort of paper materials have come out, then pencil waste must have come out. All things you should collect and keep it in a dustbin. You should not wait for your mama to help you. Right? Next, sweep and mop the floor every day. See, every day mama does this work along with cooking and all. She will sweep the mop and she will sweep the floor and then finally she will mop the house so that the house is neat and clean. That every one of us has a duty, not only mama will do, everyone in the family who are able to do the work can do it. Next, keep toys, books and other things in their proper place after use. As I said, if you are playing with your toys, if you have completed your homework, you have completed your school, completed your study work, you should assemble all the things properly and set where it should be. Books, if it should be in the cupboard, keep it in the cupboard. If it should be on the table or in your bed, put all the books in your bed and make the space or make the area clean. If you are playing with the toys or carom or ludo, whatever, you should assemble everything, you should collect everything and put it in a proper place so that the work of your mommy or your sister becomes less and they are able to carry their other work smoothly. Okay. Now next, clean the bathroom daily and must be kept dry. Now again, mother has a lot of work to do. You must be seeing every day your mama must be cleaning the bathroom, because there we take our personal care, personal hygiene care, where we brush our teeth, we take shower, we even at times you don't have your proper space to wash your clothes. At times we wash our clothes also in this bathroom. So we need to keep it clean and dry. Why? Because if a small kid or if a small member of your family, young member of your family or old member of your family enters the bathroom, they do not sit down because of soap and water level. So you need to clean your bathroom area properly and daily and keep it dry. Next, you should keep your house free from insects by putting wire mesh to prevent flies and mosquitoes from entering the house. Now you will see many of us put a wire mesh on windows and doors. Why? To prevent the insects coming in our house. Although daily we are cleaning our house, we are sweeping, we are mopping, spray also we are spraying, but then what happens, at times we find during days, especially during rainy days, you will find mosquitoes and flies wandering and they are seeing the house. But if you put a wire mesh on your windows and your doors, you can prevent them coming. This wire mesh can be dismantled, it can be washed also, so that it is not like that once it is fixed and you are not able to open it. No, you can at times weekly or monthly you can take the wire mesh out and clean it with a brush and again you can fix it. So you should use wire mesh on doors and windows to prevent the insects coming to your house. Children, today we have seen few points related to a good and clean house. Let us see few more points in our next module.